Okay, how about this one? A group of loonies go out on a day trip, and on the way back, they stop at a pub for a drink.
I think that's enough, Campbell, eh?
One of the loonies comes running up to the nurse saying, "Nurse, nurse, that barmaid smiled at me." So the nurse says, "Well, smile back." So the loony goes away, but he's back 5 minutes later saying, "Nurse, nurse, that barmaid winked at me." So the nurse says, "Well, wink back." So he's away again, but he's back 10 minutes later saying, "Nurse, nurse, that barmaid, she showed me her bosoms." So the nurse says, "Well, show her your nuts." So he's away again, straight up to the barmaid and goes, "Do you not get it?" The nurse says, "Show her your nuts," and he does!
All right, Campbell.
Have they found my kittens yet?
Francine, I told you. They were sick.
All the leaves are brown.
Thanks for the lift. She'll be all right, you know. The wee girl's tougher than you think.
Maybe.
I listened to your show on Sunday night, by the way. I thought you and Campbell were wondrous. Are you going to be famous now?
I don't think so.
Why not?
I don't know. I think we've blown it. The producer left before the show was over and nobody's been in touch since.
Caretaker let me in. Tell him I was your man.
Caretaker would have let you in if you told him you was the Yorkshire Ripper.
So, this is where you're living now?
Aye. It's not much, but...
No much? Men do intend to life live better than this.
What did you come here for?
I want you to come home. I want you to just take the drugs that we agreed, eh?
I can't do that.
How no?
I'm not going to take any more of this crapola.
You're not going to take it. I'm not going to take it. What am I supposed to tell folks when they ask after you? That you're living in a whore's drug den, tripping your syringes in the stairs, and using your industrial strength dettol to cover up the smell of stale spunk and dog shit?
It's nice to know you worry about me.
You can't stay here, Rosalie.
I know. I'm going to Hillcrest. In a leafy suburban setting. Close to shops and transport. You can help me move in if you want.
Mr. Griffin.
McKenna! And how's my top salesman this afternoon, eh?
I'm still just learning, sir.
You're going to be my right-hand man from now on, McKenna. The district council scheme starts work next week. There's plenty more where that came from. Money in the bank, McKenna. Money in the bank.
I was wondering just when the district council commission would actually be in the bank.
I know what it's like, McKenna. You want to get out there and buy that red sports car, eh? That Nikon stereo, big screen telly and video system. Is that true or am I right?
I My grandmother's emigrating. She needs £3,000.
McKenna, I'm going to tell you something I've never told any other salesman in this company. I was married once. Are you married?
No, sir.
Then take my advice. Don't ever get married. The biggest liability a salesman can have is a wife. They suck the life out of you. Margaret was always on about me not spending enough time at home. She said, Gordon, my name's Gordon, but don't ever call me that.
No, sir.
She said, Gordon, there's a parent-teacher meeting. And I said, I have to sell windows. She said, your son's been fighting. And I said, I've got to sell windows. She says, your daughter's on drugs. And I said, I have to sell windows. And when she finally up and left, do you know what I said to myself?
I've got to sell windows.
I said, good riddance to bad rubbish. Because she was trying to drag me down, McKenna, just as sure as if she was working for the competition, which I suspected she might have been when I thought about it, since she spent longer than I thought decent talking to another glaze rep at a double glazing convention once. I'm speaking to you as a father to his son. Don't ever let personal concerns drag you down. If you must, then let them pull you up to be the best salesman you can be. You want to help your grandmother? Go out and sell windows. You want quick money? Sell domestic installations. So what are you going to do?
I'm going to sell windows.
I can't hear you.
I'm going to sell windows.
That doesn't sound like my right-hand man.
I'm going to sell windows!
That's my boy!
Good afternoon. I'm Edwin McKenna, Twin View Windows. We've been left with a stuffy cancelled order and can do you a really good deal. And we offer them absolutely free, except for the cost of materials, in return for putting up a discreet Windows by Twin View sign in the front of your home. We've been looking for properties to use as show houses in the area. I couldn't help but notice what a lovely garden you've got. I'm afraid I'm only authorised to offer this discount tonight and tonight only. Well, only for the once. And you'll never regret, never regret, regret, twin regret, twin view, twin view, twin view, twin view.
I've got some work to do. I'll just sit here and do it while you two have a wee chat.
Well, once, never regret, twin view, twin view, twin view, twin view.
That's about all we have time for tonight. Don't forget to tune in tomorrow night for Campbell Bain's Looney Tunes Show.
Eddie, where the hell have you been?
Sorry, I'm late.
Late? You've missed the whole bloody show.
I've been working. Don't have to catch every one of your shows from start to finish, do I?
It was your show.
It was? Look, I'm sorry. I had a few bevvies, didn't want to drive.
A couple of bevvies? You look like you've been in a 3-day binge.
Look, Campbell, I'm a salesman. That's what I get paid for. I don't get paid for coming here.
Well, I don't think that's a very professional attitude.
What do I need a professional attitude for?
For when you go to lunch with Paula Kinghorn. She's been trying to get in touch with you for days.
Jesus.
Lunch? Eddie, lunch? And then she said,
I probably shouldn't be saying this yet, but I think I'm going to have good news for you.
I can't. You go, Campbell.
She specifically said she wanted to have lunch with you.
I can't do it.
How not?
I've been waiting for this all my life. If I went to lunch and came out with nothing, I don't know what I'd do.
You'll not come out with nothing.
I just make sure she pays for lunch.
Lunch?
Hang on, we must have passed it.
Are you sure?
No, you're right. It's further up the hill.
What are you getting these anyway, eh?
That one's got my clothes and household effects, and that one's got my debt hole. No, I'm sure this isn't right. We should have crossed a big road by now.